Hello students, once again a very warm welcome to Meso study session. So as we have discussed earlier that in today's class I'll be talking about a CBSE pattern question exercise from your chapter Microbes in Human Welfare. Now let me give you a brief introduction of this whole chapter. Microbes in Human Welfare, we have studied regarding the different type of microbes which are important for your household work, such as for the production of the curd, cheese, etc. Everything we have studied. Now next, in the case of industries, such as for the alcohol production, for the production of organic acid, for the production of antibiotic, for the production of healthcare supplements, for the production of enzyme, these microbes, they are used. And what are the different type of microbes like which are used for all these production? Everything we have studied. Now microbes, they are not only important for all these kind of things production, but also they act as a, they play a very important role in agriculture also. They act as a biocontrol agent and they also act as a biofertilizer. So this was the whole chapter. In this whole chapter we have studied n number of these microbes and their role in their respective fields. Keeping this thing in my mind that everything is clear to you, and now I'll be focusing on 10 questions from this from the chapter number 10. Yes, we will be discussing in total 10 questions, and because we have to complete this session, because you already have seen our sessions, so I'll be not going the things in detail. I'll be just discussing thing in a superficial manner. I'll be telling you if such type of questions come, what you have to write in this case. Now let's move on to the first question. Now as you can see, the first question, that is a question number 1, 2, 3, they will be of 1 mark, so you have to answer accordingly. Why do we need to add an inoculum of curd to the milk for curdling it? See, what we are producing is a curd and what we use is a inoculum, right? This inoculum we use. Why? Because these inoculum which we use, they contain million of bacteria. Now because we are producing curd, so which bacteria is important in this case? The lactic acid or lactobacillus or LAB, the lactic acid bacteria, this is important. So what it does, it helps in coagulation of milk protein, and as well as it helps in the semi digestion or the partial digestion of this protein. Along with that, in the curd there is more concentration of vitamin B12 as compared in the milk, right? So that is the reason inoculum is required, because it contains millions of bacteria, and that bacteria is important for the coagulation of milk and increasing the nutrient content as well. So this was question number 1. Now let's move on to the second question, question number 2. Mention the information that health workers derive by measuring BOD of a water body. Now here they are asking regarding the BOD. What is the full form of BOD? That is biochemical oxygen demand, right? Yes, these health worker, they measure the BOD. So if in a water, suppose I have one water body, that can be a river, that can be a pond, suppose in a water body there is more BOD. If biological oxygen demand is more in a water body, this gives us an idea that in this case the bacteria which are present, they will be more. That gives us an idea that organic substances are more. Organic substances are high. Because food is very high, that is the reason all these aerobic bacteria which are growing on them, they will be utilizing more and more oxygen. That's the reason the biochemical oxygen demand is high, and this gives us an idea that our water is polluted. Water is polluted. That is the reason health worker, they always measure the biochemical oxygen demand. So now listen to this very carefully. In a water, suppose the BOD is very high, then just keep this thing in mind, when BOD is high, it is in inversely proportional relationship with the DO. Now, what is a DO? That is a dissolved oxygen. BOD is very high, so dissolved oxygen will be very low. So dissolved oxygen will be very low. That means in this case, the biotic component of this water body, they will not be able to survive for a very long time. So what we have to do, we have to treat this water. Is it fine? Is it clear to you? Now, hope the significance of this BOD is clear to you. Now, let's talk about the next question, question number 3. Now, question number 3 is also of 1 mark. Mention the role of cyanobacteria as a biofertilizer. Yes, cyanobacteria, they act as a biofertilizer. In this case, we have one very important symbiotic relationship. Symbiotic relationship between Azolla and Anabaena. Right. Now, why it is used as a biofertilizer? Because they help in absorption of nitrogen in non-leguminous plants. Right. And the amount of nitrogen fixed by these cyanobacteria, that is around 20 to 30 this kg per hectare per year. So this much nitrogen is fixed everywhere by this cyanobacteria in a non-leguminous plant. And one example I have given, that is Azolla Anabaena. Is it clear to you? So this was again of a 1 mark question. No need to go into detail. Superficial way, you have to explain each and everything which you have studied in session. So hope you are not finding any question difficult, because these questions, they are very direct and they are directly from your notes. Now let's move on to the next question, question number 4. Name the source of cyclosporin A. How does this bioactive molecule function in our body? Now they are asking regarding this cyclosporin A. Cyclosporin A. Right. Now this cyclosporin A, this is produced by trichoderma, D-E-R-M-A. Polysporum. This is produced by Trichoderma polysporum, cyclosporin A. And what is the function of the cyclosporin A? They act as immunosuppressant. Now, what is an immunosuppressant? Suppression of immune system. So these cyclosporin A doesn't allow the activation of T cell. So if T cells will not be activated, in that case our immune system will not be able to express much, and this is given to the patient who has already undergone the surgery of transplantation. That means if the patient is having any of the foreign organ, so to prevent the rejection of that organ, cyclosporin or immunosuppressant is given. Right? Is it clear to you? Was it easy question? Yes, another very easy question directly from your notes. Now, let's move on to the next question, question number 5. How does the application, now this question is again of 2 marks. How does the application of fungal genus Glomus to an agricultural farm increases the farm output? Now they are asking regarding the Glomus. ग्लूमर्स दे एक्ट एज अ बायो फर्टिलाइजर, बायो फर्टिलाइजर. सो ग्लूमर्स इज एक्चुअली अ फंगस, इट इज एक्चुअली अ फंगस विच लिव इन सिम्बायोटिक एसोसिएशन. Symbiotic association with roots of higher plant. Of higher plant. Right? So such type of association, this is termed as mycorrhizae. This is termed as mycorrhiza. Now, what is the function of this mycorrhiza? Mycorrhiza help in absorption of phosphorus. Of phosphorus. Right? Is it clear to you? Now, there are certain other activities other function of this mycorrhiza in the agriculture. That for first thing is, it reduces the chances of root-borne diseases. Root-borne diseases reduces. So that's the reason I have used this arrow. Now, another function is, it makes a plant resistant to salinity. Resistant to salinity. Salinity as well as the dryness condition, drought. Now the third, another very important role, it helps in the growth and development of plant. Right? So, this is all about the question. What was this question? This was all about the question number 5. This is what you have to explain. Try to elaborate your answer and try to write whatever you write, just write in a clean and a point wise manner. Do not write like a story. You are not writing a story. So, wheresoever you find these important words, suppose I have written mycorrhizae, do underline it. Right? Suppose I have used the function of it, what you can do? Write in a point wise manner. Then only you will be able to get good marks in your examination. Now, let's move on to the next question, question number 6. Now, question number 6 is again of 2 marks. So, you have to answer accordingly. Now, how do mycorrhizae act as a biofertilizer? This we have already studied in previous question. You can explain regarding the glomus. Explain a genus of a fungi that form a mycorrhizal association with plant. Again, a glomus is the right answer in this case. Now, in this case, the same thing which we have studied earlier, you have to explain in this case. Now you will be asking, ma'am, you have already asked this question, then why are you asking this question again? It's just that one type of question, they can be asked in many form. So that is the biggest reason I have included this question. So glomus was there and mycorrhiza you have to explain, the function also you have to explain. So this is another way in which the question can be asked, right? Is it clear to you? Now let's move on to the next question, question number 7. Now another very important question. This is not only important for your CBSE, but for the NEET also, this is very important. Now there will be 2 questions, 7th question and 8th question. Both the question, they will be of 3 marks, so you have to answer accordingly. Question number 7 indicates, given below is a list of 6 microorganisms state their usefulness to humans. Now, they have given 6 of these and it is of 3 marks. That means each of the part they include or they must be having half marks. So you have to just explain the usefulness to human. Now the nucleopolyhedrovirus, the baculovirus they are talking about. So they act as a biocontrol agent. They help in the control of insect arthropods, and they are very specific. They are narrow. They are having a narrow spectrum, very specific. They do not cause any kind of harm to the birds as well as to the mammals. Now, next is a Saccharomyces cerevisiae. Saccharomyces cerevisiae, again, this is termed as a baker's yeast or the brewer's yeast. This is used for the production of alcohol. Alcohol, or more specifically, you can write for the ethanol production. Is it clear to you? Not only these, this is also termed as a baker's yeast because this is important for the production of cakes. Now, next is a Monascus purpureus. This is important for the production of statin. Right? And statin is a blood cholesterol reducing agent. It reduces the blood cholesterol. Next is a Trichoderma polysporum, as I have discussed earlier regarding the Trichoderma polysporum. Trichoderma polysporum, it produces cyclosporin A. Cyclosporin A. Now, what is a cyclosporin A? It is an immunosuppressant. Next is a Penicillium notatum. You will see that it helps in the production of penicillin. Now, what is a penicillin? It is an antibiotic. Antibiotic, these are those chemicals which are produced by living organism which causes harm to other living organism. Now, the Propionibacterium shermani, this is used for the production of the Swiss cheese, in which the holes are present, and these holes, they actually produced because of release of carbon dioxide. Is it clear to you? Again, it was a very easy question from your notes only, and this is a very, very, very important question. So you should have an idea about at least of these, all these six type of microbes. Now let's move on to the next question, question number 8. Now this question, again 8, is of 3 marks. Now earlier I have discussed regarding the different type of microbes. So these microbe can also be asked in this form. So there will be certain spaces which will not be having any kind of word, so you have to fill it. Now identify A, B, C, D, E, F in the table below. Now Streptococcus, as you can see, the first one, the scientific name of organism Streptococcus, it is producing a streptokinase. And this streptokinase modified. Now, what is the use in human welfare? Why it is important? Because it helps in digestion of clot removal. Right? And it is given to the patient who is suffering from myocardial infarction. Is it clear to you? So clots, suppose the clots are there, and for the dissolution of clots, the streptokinase, which is produced from the streptococcus, is given to the patient. Now I have to identify this B, which is a scientific name of organism. Product is written as a cyclosporin A. So what can be B? That is a Trichoderma polysporum. So this will be Trichoderma polysporum. Trichoderma polysporum, which produces a cyclosporin A, and here it is written as a C. So what is the function? That is, it acts as a immunosuppressant. It helps in suppressing the immune system during the transplantation. Now, Monascus purpureus, why it is important? They helps in the production of statin, right? And it reduces cholesterol. Now, next is a Lactobacillus. So, Lactobacillus, the product it produces is lactic acid. Lactic acid, and why it is important? It sets the milk into curd. Is it fine? Clear to you? Again, it was another very easy question. Now let's move on to long answer type question, which can be asked in 5 marks. So you should have an idea what you have to write in a 5 marks questions. Now this is again a very easy question, but it is asked in a different form. List the event that leads to biogas production from wastewater whose BOD has been reduced significantly. Now, in this case, you have to explain regarding the sewage treatment plant. Sewage treatment plant. So, this is a sewage treatment plant where you will be explaining the primary treatment. You will be talking about the secondary treatment. You will be talking about the tertiary treatment also. Is it clear to you? Now again you have to explain in this biogas production. So if you remember our session, in that case I have studied the whole production into 3 different reactions we have studied. That how this methanogenesis occur, how this acidogenesis occur, so everything we have studied. So what you have to do, you have to explain the different type of treatment, primary, secondary and tertiary treatment, along with those 3 reactions. Right. Now the primary treatment, it involves actually the sieving mechanism, the sieving or the filtration occur, and the second process which is followed in the primary treatment, that is a sedimentation process. So it leads to the formation of the primary effluent and the primary sludge is formed, and that primary sludge can be treated and so that a further biogas can be created. So you have to explain regarding the biogas also. So biogas, because it is a 5 marks, so you have to write a lot in this. Now, because it is a biogas, so in this case there will be presence of the methane, the H2S and the carbon dioxide, remember. Now, the secondary treatment, it involves the addition of certain aerobic bacteria into the effluent, the primary effluent. There will be presence of aerators, and which will continuously agitated, and it helps in the digestion of organic substances present in the sewage water. Now after that we follow the sedimentation process, all these whatever the bacteria which are present, that is being isolated, and it leads to the formation of the activated sludge. Some part of the activated sludge, it helps as an inoculant, it is again sent to the aerator for the further digestion. Now further, whatever the supernatant we get, that supernatant is further digested, or this is further disinfected by use of chlorine, by use of ozone, etc. So all these things you have to explain along with the production of a biogas also. All these 3 reactions, it should be like, you should write everything, then only you will get 5 marks. And what is the role of BOD, at what time we have to stop the aeration process, aerator, at what time we have to stop, regarding the BOD, what is a BOD, what is a DO, definition of BOD also. So, right, is it clear? Now let's move on to the next question, question number 10. What are biofertilizer, describe their role in agriculture, why they are preferred to chemical fertilizer. Now the biofertilizer, last session we were discussing about biofertilizer. So you have to explain each and everything in this, right? So first you will be explaining bacteria as biofertilizer. Then you will be explaining the cyanobacteria as biofertilizer. And the last, you have to explain the mycorrhiza as biofertilizer, right? Now, in bacteria as biofertilizer, we have discussed 3 parts. The free living bacteria, the symbiotic associated, right? Symbiotic. And the third one, which you have to explain in this case, that is a you can say the nitrogen fixing actinomycetes. Nitrogen fixing actinomycetes, right? Now in this case, the example we have is a Frankia symbiotic rhizobium. In this case, I am talking about the azospirillum. Now the cyanobacteria in this case, what you have to explain regarding the Azolla anabina. Now the mycorrhiza, this we have studied, this we have already discussed about, right? So this is question number 10, and this is what you have to explain. So everything, whatever you are explaining, suppose you are writing any microbes or this scientific name, they should be separately underlined. So all these mistakes you should not do. You are a biology student and you are in 12th class, you are not in 11th class. So scientific name, they should be underlined properly, and also the species name, the first letter of species name, it should be in small. So all these you can say precautions you need to take, and whenever you are starting a new, suppose you are starting a new answer, what you have to do, first of all number it, because you suppose you are writing for the question number 10, then you will write answer for the question number 10, and then you have to start explain. Wheresoever, suppose like earlier question was regarding the treatment, the sewage treatment, so you have to draw a diagram also. So wheresoever you know about the diagram, do draw the diagram. Your answer sheet should be neat and clean, and all these things so you should follow in exam, then only you will be able to get good marks in your examination. CBSE is not about writing story, it's all about whatever you know about the topic. Good thing about the topic, you have to explain it in a very beautiful manner so that you can attain good marks in your examination. So all the best for your examination. Take care of yourself. Next session I'll be starting a new chapter. Take care. Thank you so much, students, for watching this.